2, 1, 2, 3. I was headed out your door, determined that I would go, when a tornado warning came on a music show. I was scared of the howling wind blowing around the town, so I quickly changed my plans and I settled down. Yeah, but it was no tornado. Saved by the warmest part of your soul. I looked to the east, birds were flying by. I looked to the west, I saw a darkened sky. All of the world was turning, all in that dreadful storm.
Okay, we're back. Kevin Hives telling my stories as a childhood, as a guy growing up. I'm writing a book. I think I've said that every time. Also, I have a YouTube page, so subscribe or thumbs up or TikTok and TikTok and all that kind of stuff. When you see all of them, just, you know, do all those things. But anyway, I want to start off this little session today by giving a little bit of a, I'll say, disclaimer. And what was the other word I was going to use?
Confession.
A little bit of a confession and disclaimer. You see, I have many stories, probably 70 or 80 stories, probably more than that. And many of these stories start when I was a little kid, 4, 5, 6 years old, all the way up to current, actually. And during some of the stories, I'm probably going to say some things that probably aren't politically correct. I mean, my daughter wakes me up all the time, so I can be a very woke guy when I need to be, and I'm not trying to make fun of that. But back then, I'm telling the stories from the perspective of a little kid or a teenager at that time. So I'm going to be saying the things that I would have said back then to make it, you know, part of the story. But that doesn't mean I have any disrespect for any of the comments that I make about types of people or things like that, and especially about my family members. So, you know, I got a call from my sister, and she very tactfully and very nicely said, "Kev, you're saying stuff on those videos that's kind of making us feel a little bit." And I didn't really understand, because, again, I tried to explain that. I'm saying it from a perspective of a kid who have a kid things, but I did say things like my mom is very cheap. And listen, I got to tell you something. My mom was the best mom you could ever get. I mean, we were very blessed, our family. I mean, when I say she was cheap, she was frugal. My mom, I gotta tell you, we had that house in Levittown. I remember when she went and got a job, because we really were tight on money. We couldn't make the mortgage payment. And I remember her arguing with my dad and saying, "We are not losing this house. I'm going to get a job." And he said, "I don't want you working. I want you home with the kids." Because back in the 60s, that's kind of the way it was. And she said, "I don't care what you want. I'm getting a job. We're not losing this house." I remember that conversation. I also remember her counting pennies off the kitchen table to make the mortgage payment. So my mom was very focused and very frugal and a very good handler of our funds, and I love her and respect her for that. So when I say she's cheap and she would water in the ketchup bottle and stuff, those are comical statements. But that doesn't mean that she was cheap. She was frugal, and it doesn't mean that she wasn't a good mom. She was an amazing mom. Matter of fact, I can remember one time, and, you know, my stories always lead to stories, so I guess my little apology / disclaimer pitch here turns into a story. But I can remember when she did get a job. She had a job at a restaurant called Fiesta, and it turned into Lums or something like that, and she was a waitress, and she could not afford a babysitter. And I can remember her taking me and my brother Mike with her to this restaurant in our pajamas, and she would put us in a closed section of the restaurant, and we would sit there in the booth and play with our army men and dinosaurs and stuff while she waitressed and made not very much money and made a few tips, but she worked to make sure we didn't lose our house. She took care of her family, and my dad was the same way. Some of the stories I'm going to tell are going to be about some semi-comical things that my dad may have done when he was a little under the influence. My dad was life of the party, and I know exactly what it means, because before I became a Christian, I was life of the party too, in the bars and all that kind of stuff. Doesn't make him a bad person, didn't make me a bad person. And back then, listen, he had the stress of 5 kids and having to, you know, feed those mouths. He worked 2, 3, 4 jobs sometimes. Was very loyal to my mom. Never messed around. They had a great marriage. Mm-hmm. They were great folks. They gave us great morals. Raised what I think are great kids. So I'm going to say things the way they are, coming out truthfully. from the perspective of how I thought and saw them back in that day. But I do not mean to disrespect anybody or put anybody down, certainly personally, and certainly not any group of people. I believe I'm a good-hearted Christian guy, but I'm not a perfect guy. Never was, probably never will be. Anyway, I wanted to make that pitch and this little videotape of 2 or 3 minutes, my, like I said, my disclaimer, and my, what do I call it again?
Confession.
My confession, and my apology to some degree, for sometimes not really saying things the right way. Anyway, you have a wonderful day. I've got more stories coming. We'll see you later.